Hello everyone, I'm Nate Asher and welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker HD. In the last episode, we made our way through the Tower of the Gods and got the command melody. And in this episode, we'll be using the command melody to finish out this temple. Grappling hook in this game, hookshot in, well, it's still in this game, but we don't have the hookshot yet. Alright, so here's where we're going to be utilizing the command melody. We're going to get this guy down from here. Remember what the command melody is. I believe it's here. First, we gotta stand on this. I wish there was a way to like speed up the rate to hop around. Going to tell us now.
Link, it is I, the King of Red Lines. Afraid there are some areas to which you will not be able to bring the servants of the tower. Do not fear leaving them behind. Once you have awakened them, they will wait patiently for your return. Of this I assure you. Good. Good.
So, the way they did this is so complicated. I do not know why it couldn't have just been like a cross, like a plus sign or something that you latch onto. So much easier. Alright. This crap. Is this the first time we're fighting an Iron Knuckle? All you have to do is hold the left trigger and just keep pressing A whenever he tries to attack you. Of course, it won't work if he's unarmed. So why is not? Grab your sword. Use your own sword to crack open your orb. Feels bad. Alright, so that thing I just picked up there is the one of the knight's crests that we have to bring to Orca. We just need 10 of those.
Hey,
Now we got the hero's bow. Alright. That one. But before I go in the final flashing room over there, I want to go back in this first room because there's now something we can do that we have, or now that we have the bow, besides kill that guy. A heart. Oh well. At least I got to show it off. Let the record show that I did not remember it being so useful. Really, I don't think that. Well, no, I did play it through once, but I was gonna say I have more experience with the GameCube version. Than I do with the HD Wii version. So, not sure how many details are different, but that will be a factor. Right. Let's see. I guess. A lot more areas in this temple than I remember. Granted, I do tend to skip the beginning. Man, if this was Ocarina of Time, I'd be nailing these. Even Breath of the Wild, a lot better. Okay. Here we can go ahead and hit that one. let me. Oh. What? What the heck was that void out? You see how I like moved? Fake you out. I would like to get This is not going very smoothly. To say the least. Not what I needed. Can I make it? No! I will take the small key, sir. Not everything is the bomb. Another joy pendant? Goodness. Maybe they took away, like, rubies. I just remember this. Game not having so many of the freaking joy pendant things. Wish I had bomb air. Could be. Oh, well, we're out of magic now. Thank you. fair? See how it is. Oh man, I had my doubts if these would have anything in them. But they do. Oh, I forgot to take those off. I just need magic right now. All they're giving me is bombs and arrows. And nothing. And rupee. Alright, so what you gotta do in this room is you're trying to get that guy, but these things hurt. And stand on this, make them disappear, but then how are you gonna get in there? By the way, if you look, hard to see. Maybe I can do it with my pills. See the pattern on there? It's a Triforce, but it's also, if you look really closely, see those squiggles that are going out in three like that? Just remember that. Keep it in mind. Zoom in again. You have the three squiggles going out like that, the triangles, and then the points going off. Like the three little things, like that one at the bottom, that one up there, and that one right there. So, just remember that for, it's a cool reference that I will elaborate on later, but as for right now, which this is also a cool design, just take a minute to admire all this. Like, someone had to design all of this, even the floor. Like, look at the floor. Like, it actually looks like a design. And on this thing, that's design. Even way up there. Just neat. Look, even this. That's why I love this series so much. Anyway. A couple of different ways to solve this. You can, hopefully, just fly over there with your Korok leaf. But if you don't have the leaf, which, the way I always did it, like, I never even thought to use the leaf. I always would just jump on one of these things here. I usually use the right side. I don't know why, just for some reason, I feel like it works better. But, if you don't have magic, you can grab on this. And just get in like that. Just if you don't have magic, so. I've never tried to throw this guy. I don't know if you can do it. No. That's not gonna work. See, he can move through this no problem though, so you don't have to throw him at all. I just was curious how far it would travel. Now that he's on here, you're not gonna get a cutscene, so it might be confusing. You might not know what to do, but if you turn around, that's gone. But as long as you keep him right there, Link can get back there. Now, since this is the last guy, we're going to get attacked on our way back. So the only way to get that guy, the statue, or the, what do they call him, weren't guardians, what did, the King of Red Lions refer to them as, can't remember. Servants of the temple, I believe he called them. So if you throw all those guys down there, then this is going to be, it'll be heavy enough that this platform won't change its height level, even with you and the statue on it at once. Finally, I get some magic out of these pots. Jeez, these pots never give anything helpful. Now I gotta check all of them. I'm not sure now. I'll take the 10 rupees, jeez. Just because I never see the 10 rupees. Did I start on the far side? Alright. Thought we were done. Funny. Alright, so what you can do is See, what I like about this, and I don't understand why it wasn't in, Ocarina of Time or Majora's Mask, you can walk forward and backward with this. Now that we have arrows, it's a lot easier to kill this guy. We don't have to wait for him to shoot us while holding a bomb. Much better. Joy pendant for some reason. Alright, so, as you can see, this is the boss key. Can't go through that door, so what are we supposed to do? How do we get the boss key, and how do we get through the door? See this, you think like, like, we can't hold down all three of these things. Actually, something I want to try real quick. I wonder if I could... Maybe I set a bomb. I went too early. Bombs on this, they take forever. Just needed to blow me upward. Push me into I can't even do it with invincibility thing. But could I get there from here? That is a question. I think that might be possible. I think that is possible, man. That is cool. Sorry for this little thing that's taking time. I just wanted to test this out. Oh, I bet if I leaf pumped it, it would work. Got out of magic, though. Dang. Oh, well. Anyway, you gotta get close to these guys. Come to life. Shoot him. Get their back. Oh. grappling hook those guys because they give you golden feathers. Same with the pea hats, the little baby pea hats. I see these blue ones, they're only gonna go straight in front of them, but they will block you off. They're pretty easy to get. But the pink ones, you can kinda tell the difference just by looking. So the pink ones, are the ones that spin around. Yeah, those guys, they're just staying put. Pink ones spin around, and those are the ones that will follow you. We're only getting the golden feathers because of a side quest that I can't remember if we already tried it or not. I may have already done it whenever I was at Dragon Roost. If not, then that's fine because I'm still collecting them anyway. Oh, I have an empty bottle too. Come here, fairy. Alright, so we're gonna need this. There we go. Rupees. Arrows. Do this, guys. Look at the tail on this too. Those are all like Chica outfit, like early X, like way before Breath of the Wild. Like got a actual like alphabet figured out, but Oh, chosen one. Except this one. Alright, so these are kind of like the Sheikah, the shrines in Breath of the Wild, where it's like a friendly challenge. Did show it off, but you may not have caught it if you weren't looking for it. So see, he'll fly around, you hit him in the eye, and he'll start to charge up his thing. If you go right underneath him, he'll stop. And you get an extra hit in. Yeah. I found out it was too late. When I was younger, I thought it was like a little bit tough, especially when you can't avoid those like beams and everything, but the fact that it's not, he's not like evil, it's more of a trial or a test, kind of like alleviates some of the pressure, I think. But anyway, that's going to do it for this episode, guys. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like. I really do appreciate it. Seriously, like, if you like the video, then just click the like button. I mean, come on. But anyway, in the next video, we're gonna be seeing what we've unlocked from this trial. So I'll see you all then. Bye.